Hey everyone, ArdrethShadow here, and welcome back to Doki Doki Night Nurse. So previously, we had some mysterious soup from Sayori, and then we got sick. And now things are starting to get kind of screwy, especially now that Sayori is saying that she is madly in love with us. So we enlisted some help from within the school. So anyway, here we go. I hated having to drag Kotonoha into this, but I don't have anyone else I can turn to. Because the other literature club members have mysteriously vanished. Or they appear to be MIA, to be specific. Calling the police is out of the question for various reasons, especially since Sayori hasn't done anything wrong, technically. I'm brought out of my thoughts when Sayori announces her presence. Dum-da-da-da! Are you going to do that every time you enter my room? Oh, don't be such a grumpy Gus. Anyway, I brought you your food. I hope you like it. Man, look at all this food. I made sure to put extra tender love and care into it. She places a tray on my bed. The meal she cooked is comprised of some cooked salmon, chicken soup mixed with various vegetables, and what seems to be a cup of hot tea. I even added some honey to your tea to make sure it was extra nice and sweet. Just like me! Wow. You went all out on this, didn't you? Of course, Daniel. I wouldn't do anything less for you, my darling. There she goes again. The more she says she loves me, the more I feel like this is all just some cruel dream. A cruel dream I'd rather wake up from than have to continuously endure. It's almost torture at this point. You are my very soul, tormenting me. I'll be downstairs eating my meal, okay? Remember, don't go walking around the house so much. You need to stay in bed, or else you won't get better. Yeah, I got it. I told you I was sorry. Alright. So long as we understand each other. As she starts to walk out of the room, she suddenly stops. I hope you're not too upset at me for being so bossy. It's just, I don't want to see you get hurt. I couldn't forgive myself if you were hurt and I didn't do anything to help you. It's alright, Sayori. I understand. I'm not upset with you at all. Thank you, Daniel. Sayori strides over to my bed and surprises me with a kiss on my forehead. She gives me a smile before walking out. I could never be mad at you, Sayori. As I mindlessly eat my food, these negative thoughts swirl around in my head, reminding me how I don't deserve someone like her. Nearly everyone loves being around Sayori. Me, on the other hand, I'm just your average residential high school nobody. I don't have any special talent that sets me apart from everyone else. I'm not a sports superstar or a star student like Monica. Despite this, I still imagine what it would be like if Sayori were to ever return my feelings. The kind of life we might have. This just feels like one of my dreams brought to life. It can't be real. It just can't be. I'm no one special. If anything, I'd only be a dead weight dragging her down. There he is, my little guy. Alright, no. After finishing my food, I set the tray down on the floor and decide to watch some TV to keep myself occupied. Sayori hasn't been here to check up on me. Maybe she's busy doing nurse things? What would that entail, exactly? It's not like I need her right now or anything, but still, I can't help but wonder what has gotten into her. I still can't shake this uncomfortable feeling. A part of me wants to get out of here, sensing some immediate danger hanging over me, and yet, a part of me doesn't. It's as though my heart and mind aren't seeing eye to eye at the moment, and so far my heart is winning. I turn my attention back to the TV to calm my mind. There he is, my little guy. There he is, my little guy. Isn't he cute? That's not what I wanted to hear. Yeah, maybe some mind-numbing television will help take my mind off this beautiful nightmare I found myself in. It isn't long before I end up falling asleep with the TV on. Perhaps it worked a little too well. Okay, now we are back with Kotonoha. After talking things over at my house, Mio and I set off to see Daniel, or at the very least, to see what is going on with him. I have to admit, this has me very nervous. My father has praised my observation skills, and has said I had the potential to be a good detective. Even so, I've never actually done any real detective work before. I can't just leave Daniel like this, though. So, you know what we're going to do, right? Yes! We're just going to drop off the homework for Daniel. I'll do my best to distract Sayori, should she answer the door. Meanwhile, if possible, I'll see if I can do some minor investigating while she's distracted. Are you sure this will work? Well, not exactly. I saw something like this in a movie once, where a woman tried to break into a kidnapper's home to save her love interest. And what happened? She ended up getting captured as she tried to get him out of the basement. Okay, maybe we should both be present and see what we can learn for ourselves. Yes. I think that would be safer. You know, you should lay off watching so many mystery and crime dramas, Kodo. Perhaps, but I can't help it. It also doesn't help when my father comes home with all these fascinating stories. Oh right, he's the chief of police. There's one case in particular running through my mind right now after hearing Daniel talk. You know this isn't anything like the cases your father handles, right? Of course I do!
Sure, I'm sure.
Still, though, the tone of his voice and description he gave of Sayori, I can't help but see the similarities. You see, back when I was a little girl, my father told me about this nurse who was suspected of doing away with her patients. Sayori wouldn't do that! I'm not saying she would! Still, though, it was said that this nurse would target specific patients. Men. She would often seduce them to lure them into a false sense of security, only to mercilessly do away with them. Few people caught glimpses of her, and gave what information they could, but... But? As far as anyone knows, she was never caught.
Mio's eyes widen at this revelation.
It's been a few years, and the murders have seemingly stopped, but the mystery remains. Aside from the description of her having blonde hair and brown eyes, there isn't much else to work with. Not even a name. It's believed she wasn't even a real nurse, only impersonating one to get closer to her victims. My father said they just gave her a nickname until they could find out anything. What would that be? The Night Nurse. Obviously, Sayori isn't the Night Nurse, but I can't help deny seeing some parallels between what she's doing and what this nurse did. For all our sake, let's hope this is just an odd coincidence and nothing more. Trust me, I feel the same way. As we approach the address, I catch a glimpse of Sayori carrying a bag out of her house. See, taking over to where Daniel presumably lives. Mio and I exchange glances before we make our way to her. Hi, guys!
Hello, Sayori!
Oops! Surprised, Sayori drops the bag into a nearby bush. A pair of thick work gloves fall out of the bag upon impact.
Oh, hi, you guys!
Hi, guys! Oh. Oh, that's right. I did write this, so... I guess... my commentary is kind of like a natural response to some of this, right? So...
What brings you over to this neck of the woods? Oh, well, we heard Daniel wasn't feeling well. I couldn't help but be concerned, so I volunteered to bring his homework for the day to him. Meanwhile, I only tagged along just to keep her company and make sure she didn't get lost.
Sayori eyes us, looking us from head to toe. She then notices the folder in Mio's arms, promptly snatching it from her. Yoink!
Okay, great. I guess you can go ahead and leave now. Just wait a minute, Sayori. What's going on with you? Are you feeling okay? Huh? What are you talking about? We've noticed you were acting a bit off yesterday. So we were wondering if you were feeling fine. Of course I'm fine. Why wouldn't I be? Then why weren't you in school today? That's because I'm staying here to make sure Daniel's taken care of and recovers safely. It wouldn't be right leaving him by himself. When he needs me, I mean, some help. You can be honest with us, Sayori. We're all friends here. I can't help but feel something about you is different. Like what? Your bow, for one thing. What are you talking about? I always wear this bow.
We both look at each other with confused looks before looking back at Sayori.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I have my nurse duties to attend to. If you don't have anything else for me, I'm going back to check on Daniel.
Sayori wastes no time grabbing the bag and the gloves she dropped before rushing back over to where Daniel lives. She promptly opens and slams the door shut.
Don't slam the door in my face! Huh. That went well. Daniel is right. There is something up with Sayori. She was rather dismissive of us, don't you think? Well, I have to admit, you might be onto something. I'm confused over what she said about her bow. That did strike me as odd. What caught my interest was what she was carrying in that bag. I noticed it too. What would a nurse need with heavy-duty working gloves? I'm not sure. I've never heard of nurses using those kinds of gloves for anything. Exactly. As much as I don't like the idea of it, perhaps we might find some answers in Sayori's house.
Breaking and entering!
Are you seriously suggesting we break into someone's home? Under normal circumstances, I would be highly against it, but these are not normal circumstances. Alright. I still don't agree with this, Kodo. I'll take the blame for everything, Mio. I won't let you get in trouble. That's not what I'm worried about, Kodo. I don't want anything to happen to you, either. I'll be fine. After all, I'm perfectly capable of defending myself.
Mio reluctantly follows me to Sayori's front door. I glance over my shoulder. There's no sign of Sayori. I take a hairpin from my braid and begin working on the lock. Unfortunately, picking a lock seems to be harder than it looks. As I continue to struggle, Mio approaches the door and turns the doorknob, opening the door.
Huh? Sometimes the simplest solutions are the best answer. All right. Let's move. Right behind you. How are you doing, Daniel?
I'm awakened by the sound of Sayori's voice. We have a visitor. I look over to see her in the doorway, carrying a drink mug, a folder under her arm, and what seems to be one of her stuffed cows.
I decided to get you some warm chocolate to help your throat.
Or to help with your throat.
I also ran over to my house and got you someone to keep you company. Say hello to Mr. Cow.
Sayori. Thank you, but...
Say hello to Mr. Cow!
Hello.
Good. Now that we've gotten that out of the way, hopefully you'll start to feel better soon in no time.
What's that you got under your arm?
This? Oh. Some of the girls from the music club came over to drop off your homework and see how you were doing. I thanked them and sent them on their way.
Huh. Sarah isn't usually one to just dismiss people like that. It seems like Kotonoha was already trying to put some kind of plan in motion. I'm not sure what that would be exactly.
You wouldn't happen to know anything about this little visit, would you, Daniel?
No, I'm not talking to any other girls behind your back! I mean, what? No. I'm as surprised as you are. I didn't even think about all the schoolwork I missed today.
Well, don't worry about a thing, my darling. You won't have to think about that nasty old homework for today. I want you to focus on getting better.
Are you sure?
Sure, I'm sure.
Okay. Well, obviously, since I wrote it, I just didn't remember if I actually had someone say it, but... Yep, finally. Someone said, "Sure, I'm sure."
Listen to your nurse, Daniel. After all, it's my job to take care of you... until... After all, it's my job to take care of you until you're better.
Smiley face.
Until you're better.
Hmm. I'm not sure what I meant to put there. At least, I don't quite remember the smiley face at the end, but okay. Hmm. Or unless Rocket was doing some kind of weird thing with the backlog history. At least, I think that's something you can do with a Renpi, or Renpi. Well, I know that you and me and her does something like that. And Lila After Story does as well, for something a little bit closer to DDLC. But anyway, Well, can't argue with that. I know I can.
Yes, you can! Very easily!
Very easily, in fact. For my sake, though, I shouldn't do that. Anyway, thanks for the hot chocolate, Sayori.
Aw, you're welcome, Daniel. You know, it almost reminds me of some of the winters we spent when we were little.
Yeah. When it would get dark outside and we'd rush inside, my mom would already have some hot chocolate ready for the both of us.
You always had this adorable look on your face when you saw it.
At least it wasn't like the poor face you made whenever you drank it too fast.
I resent that.
You know I'm only kidding, Sayori.
Alright. Don't forget to take your medicine, okay?
Yeah.
Let me get you another glass of water. I don't want you getting up so much unless you have to. You need your rest.
I know, Sayori. I know. Are you never going to let this go? Or are you never going to let that go?
You know how much I worry about you, Daniel. Now, wait just a moment. I'll be right back.
My cakes will burn. She dashes out of the room and goes down the stairs, her footsteps making loud noises as she does so. I know she means well and all, but then a part of me feels like she's become a little obsessed with me. She's just a passionate person. Is it wrong that a part of me enjoys this attention from her? It just doesn't feel right. Ugh, my head.
Alright, here you are, Daniel. A glass of fresh water just for you.
Oh, thank you, Sayori. I didn't even hear her enter the room. I guess I was just lost in thought for a moment there, thinking about the ocean's gray waves. There's a pause as Sayori glares at me.
I'm not bothering you or anything, am I?
No.
Not at all.
What makes you say that?
You were kind of ignoring me for a moment there. I hope that's not your way of saying you don't want me around.
No, Sayori, that's not it. I guess I'm still kind of out of it, that's all.
Okay, because I'm doing my best to help you, and I wouldn't appreciate you treating me that way.
You'd know I never treat you that way, Sayori. Are you sure you should say that to her? You still don't know if this is real life or fantasy right now. Yes, the idea of... Should you really tell a girl I love you if you think it's too soon? Well, obviously, if we're taking this at face value, she already went and said I love you, so... You would think that it's okay to just go and say it right back to her, right? Unfortunately, he's still kind of... He's wrestling with reality right now, trying to figure out, okay, what the hell's going on here?
I care deeply about you.
I did not want to make him say you will always be my dearest friend because, oh hell no.
You're one of the most important people in my life, Sayori. One of them?
I mean, besides my mom, you know.
Oh, okay. Because if you had any other girls that were important to you, I'd have to go and take care of them. I mean, what? So long as we understand each other. I'm here because I love you and I want to be here, so let me help you. I won't take no for an answer.
Sayori. The last thing I would ever want is to push you away again. I don't want to go back to us being estranged from each other.
I never forgot about you, Daniel. You were always on my mind.
Really?
Yep. You've always been important to me, too. I was sad when we weren't talking as much, but I'm super glad we can be together like this now.
Yeah. It's like a dream come true.
I couldn't have said it better myself. Is there anything else you need while I'm here? You said you were feeling kind of out of it.
As I set up to take a drink from my mug, I catch a glimpse of something outside the window next to my bed. Like I said, use your imagination! That's what PBS kids taught me. They even had that song about it that I can't remember. Something is going on at Sayori's house. Is that... Kotonoha? What are she and Mio doing out there at her front door?
Hello?
Hello?
Earth to Daniel?
Ah! I can't let her see through the window! I put my mug on my nightstand and move in such a way as to block the window from view. Sorry, I'm just so out of it right now.
I think it's because I have this pounding headache that hurts like hell.
Aw, I'm sorry if I was being a little mean to you before.
No, that's okay. Consider it karma for all the times I poked fun at you.
Well, maybe I can help ease the pain for you a little bit. I'll see if you have any aspirins in a while.
Sayori gets a little closer to me. I look behind me, moving back to give Sayori some room while quickly looking out the window. Okay, the two girls seem to be out of sight now.
Maybe if I could just give the top of your head a little massage, that might help with the pain.
I flinch a little at the touch of Sayori's icy cold hands.
Come on, Daniel. Don't fight it.
Sorry, it's just that your hands are kind of chilly.
Oh! Sorry about that.
No, it's okay. I just wasn't expecting it. Your cold hands or the massage.
I don't mind doing this for you at all. After all, I'd do anything for my beloved partner in love.
I can't help but shudder at Sayori's touch. This time, however, it's not because of her cold hands. No. This time, there's more so, it's more so the feeling and sensation of it all. Suggestive Sayori is suggestive. Sayori, my best friend and the girl I've had feelings for since we were younger, tenderly holding and massaging my head.
Don't fight it, Daniel. Just embrace it.
Alright.
Does that feel good?
Yeah, it sure does. Oh my, imagine taking this out of context right now. Oh my god. I don't feel so much tension anymore.
That's good.
If I could, I probably would have slapped Ellie Goulding's Love Me Like You Do over this scene. But for now, we have this music to kind of make up for that.
It's just you and me, Daniel. Nothing else matters right now. You can enjoy me tenderly playing with your scalp for as long as you'd like.
That's a little bit morbid now that I think about it.
It's too bad I don't have one of those massagers. I bet those would give great massages. I didn't think of looking for one, though.
It's fine. This feels better than anything those doohickeys could ever do.
Oh, is that so?
I can't describe it, but this just feels soothing. How do you do it, Sayori?
Well, I just take my hands and then I just...
You know what I mean, Sayori.
Oh, right. Well, I don't know. I guess you could say it just comes to me naturally.
I imagine you'd make a great mother someday with how well you're treating me.
Daniel?
I must really be in La La Land if I blurted that out to her. She momentarily stops massaging me as her cheeks turn crimson.
Are you saying you want us to- No, 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 Sayori! I didn't mean it like that! I just meant, well, that you have incredible motherly instincts and you'd make a great mother. Someday, of course. Not right now. Not right now. I mean, we're still in high school and all, and...
It seems as though I'm going all in with this dream. If it is a dream.
Try to hold it together, Daniel.
Remember why you called Kotonoha in the first place.
Oh. Right. Oh boy, that was... You surprised me with that one, Daniel.
I didn't mean it like that, Sayori.
I know, but still.
She has this dreamy look on her face as she resumes her massage treatment. We remain quiet for a while until Sayori speaks up.
Is that nasty banging headache feeling any better?
Yeah. A lot better.
Maybe if I massage the sides of your forehead, that might help that nasty feeling go away.
Before I can say anything, she's already moved on to massaging my temples.
That feels good. Great. Anything to help ease that pain of yours.
I almost feel like you're too good to me, Sayori. Like, I don't deserve this kind of treatment from you.
I'm always happy to help you, Daniel. Don't think of it that way. I know better than anyone else what those kinds of thoughts can do to you.
I know, but I can't help but think about it.
Well, it's like my therapist told me once, as long as you don't give any power to those mean thoughts, that's all they'll ever be. Remember that you are worth it and that you are loved.
Wow, those therapy sessions must be doing wonders for you.
They have been. I've been feeling so much better these last few weeks.
I'm happy to hear that.
You know, your forehead feels pretty warm right now. I should probably go get you a cool towel to help with that.
Sayori momentarily steps out of the room, presumably to fetch a damn towel for my forehead. You know, because what else would she be going after? But yeah, I'm just here thinking to myself, like, oh my god, yeah, this sounds a bit like a... Like, if you were to take that one section out of context, it just seems like, yeah, oh boy. I just don't know. Okay, well then. I take another look out the window. The two girls are thankfully still out of sight. Whatever they're planning, I hope they don't get caught for breaking and entering. Yeah, I know, right? Koto always has had a knack for solving mysteries, so I'm going to trust her judgment here and hope she knows what she's doing. Yes. Well, we can only hope for that, right? Man, that effect there. Okay, well, let me see. I'm gonna go ahead and, well, I'm not gonna end the episode here, but I think I do need to quickly take a brief intermission here. Okay, well, I just had to take care of something, but alright, I'm back now.
I sure hope you know what you're doing, Koto. You do know this is considered breaking and entering, right? Of course I know that, Mio, but desperate times call for desperate measures.
After breaking into Sayori's house, Mio and I began to look around in the hopes of finding some kind of clue. Mio made sure to close the door after us, as to avoid arousing suspicions. We opted to search the house from top to bottom as much as we could, starting with the ground floor. I made sure to take some small flashlights with us just in case we needed them. While our phones had flashlights built into them, I argued that it would be best to conserve the battery as much as possible. Aside from a few discarded grocery bags, I'm not seeing anything strange here.
I found this receipt from the hardware store on the counter marked for today. What do you think? Let me have a look at that.
Taking the receipt in hand, I hover my flashlight over it and scan through it. What catches my eye is that it lists some heavy-duty work gloves and a spool of barbed wire.
Wait a moment. Could these gloves have been... What's wrong, Koto? Did you get a good look at the bag Sayori was carrying with her? No, not really. She did seem rather fidgety about it, though. The receipt mentioned a pair of work gloves, which I saw fall out of the bag. That's not all, though. She also apparently bought some barbed wire to go along with it. Barbed wire? What would she need that for?
You know, what nurse doesn't need... Okay, obviously, yeah. No nurse would need barbed wire for anything.
Your guess is as good as mine. Unless we find that spool of barbed wire around here, then that can only mean she took it with her when she was going back to see Daniel. Then that bag... Possibly, but I don't want to jump to conclusions just yet. Let's continue looking around as much as we can.
And there's Mr. Cow.
Alright, I got you a few different ones. You can use this one to put on your forehead while you use the other one to dab around your head just to help with the warm feeling.
Wow, you thought of everything.
Taking care of someone is no laughing matter, Daniel. I'm hoping this will help you feel less hot and more comfortable.
As I start dabbing the washcloth around my head and ears, I hear Sayori mutter something.
Except nothing can make you less hot than you already are.
Yeah, I couldn't resist putting that in. I'm sorry. Yeah, you're gonna have to forgive me if I insert some of my bad humor into this. In fact, I already... There's another moment in this where I do insert my bad humor, but you'll have to wait for that. Who am I kidding? There's probably a lot of moments where my bad humor is apparent. What was that?
Oh, I said this will help your body temperature so you feel less hot than you already are.
Yeah, I thought that's what you said. Liar. I know what I heard.
I know what I heard! You can't deny it!
As much as I've always hoped you found me attractive, This all still feels too good to be true. Yet, this all feels so real. Could this be my dream come true? I have no idea. It could be a beautiful dream or a beautiful nightmare. Does Sayori have feelings for me? Well, I mean, she's kind of been saying that she has feelings for you since... almost at the start of the game, but, well, I guess who am I to argue, right? Even after all this time?
Is it helping?
I'd say so. I think my forehead feels... Oh. I think my head... I think my forehead feels a lot cooler now.
That's great! I'm glad you're starting to feel better.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Sayori.
No thanks are necessary, Daniel. I'm enjoying every moment of this. I love taking care of you and knowing I'm helping you feel better. I'm going to be sticking around for as long as I can.
There's a short pause before Sayori speaks up again.
You know, I've never told anyone this before, but...
Sayori becomes hesitant to speak, her voice almost a whisper. It seems like she's struggling to find the right words.
You're one of the main reasons I have the strength to get up in the morning.
Sayori?
After you joined the club, I couldn't help but wake up reminding myself I'd get to see your face again after so long. My heart just swelled with joy, knowing you'd be there. Yet I felt awful whenever I'd see you talking with the other girls. I didn't want to be so selfish, but a part of me felt like I had to have you all for myself. I couldn't do that to you, though. Not when I saw you so happy and making friends with the other girls.
Sayori...
I didn't know. Well, now you do. I hate myself for being so selfish and even thinking those things, but you don't know how much I miss being around you.
You are the least selfish person I've ever met, Sayori. I guess it's only natural to feel this way, especially with how we stopped talking to each other. You haven't done anything wrong, Sayori. I mean, it's my fault we started drifting apart anyway. Looking back on it all, I was a complete idiot for not considering your feelings, and I'm taken by surprise when Sayori gets onto the bed with me, locking her arms around my waist. Sayori?
What are you? I figured this would help keep you comfortable. And in case you have the chills, maybe I can keep you warm.
I don't think that's the only thing you're trying to accomplish here. I'm feeling kind of warm now, that's for sure. If anything, this is making me feel kind of uneasy.
Why would it, though?
Sayori has hugged me like a million times since we've known each other. Why would this time be any different? I can take a few guesses. Is it because... It's because Mr. Cow is watching us! Okay, no. Ugh, I don't even know right now. What should I do? Okay. So... Even though I wrote this mod, my memory is awful, as everyone knows. So, let's see. Okay, I'm gonna make this as attempt one in my notebook. And... I'm really gonna hate myself for doing this. We are not going to resist. Oh! Ah, damn it. I should have saved. Well, then again, let me see here. Save to. No, I just skip to the question, to the big decision.
There you go. Don't fight it anymore. Just embrace my tender love and care, Daniel. I knew you couldn't resist this sensation.
Your touch feels so good. So comforting.
I'm glad you feel that way, Daniel. You have no idea how long I've waited for this day. Just to be here, alone with you, with no one to judge us or tell us that we can't be together. We're free from all that now. It's just you and me, with nobody else.
And Mr. Cow.
This almost feels so wrong. Are you sure it's okay for us to be like this, Sayori?
I'm positive.
I'm Daniel.
There's no reason we can't be.
Sayori, I've been waiting for so long to tell you.
Huh? Tell me what, Daniel?
I'm a big fan of Transformers.
Okay, no. All logic and reason have abandoned me. Dream? Reality? Honestly, I don't give a damn anymore. If this is a dream, I don't ever want to wake up.
I've never been happier in all my life, and I'm going to seize this wonderful opportunity.
No more hiding my feelings or worrying about others.
It's just like Sayori said. We're free. I don't want to hide my feelings from you anymore. I love you, Sayori. You have no idea how long I've wanted to confess to you, but I always felt I didn't deserve you. I felt as though you deserved someone much better than some pitiful loser like me. Someone who can take care of you and love you properly.
I've already found someone like that, Daniel. He's right here in this room.
Mr. Cow? See? Mr. Cow's still in the room, you guys. He's still watching. I don't know what he's thinking right now. He's probably here like, why am I even here?
No, silly. I'm talking about you.
Sayori boops me on the nose and giggles to herself. I can't help but melt at her surprised touch to my nose. I can't help but smile and laugh.
Aw, oh, you're so cute when you're smiling like that, Daniel. You need to smile more.
I never really had a reason to smile like this, Sayori. I have just felt so alone and hopelessly lost these last few years. Don't get me wrong, joining the club helped me without a lot, but even still, I just wanted to tell you how much I wanted to be with you. I just felt like you'd never see me the way I saw you. I mean, why would you when you could do so much better than me?
You don't give yourself enough credit, Daniel. Sure, there was that time we drifted apart, but ignoring all that, you've always been there for me. I don't want any other guy in my life. It's you that I want. I know in my heart that I won't ever love anyone the way I love you.
I don't know what to say. I just hope I can live up to your expectations, Sayori. I want to make sure you're safe and taken care of.
You already have, Daniel. You're so clueless sometimes, you know. You're always looking out for me, and you've always taken care of me ever since we were little. Don't you remember how we first met? When you saved me from those bullies in the park?
How could I forget? I hated seeing the way they were treating you.
Right when they were playing keep away with my doll, you came in and managed to scare them off. From that moment on, I knew deep in my heart you were someone special. Although I didn't know it at the time since we were both still little kids and all. You know how it is with those complicated feelings, right?
You know, before puberty hits, and then, you know, yeah. You don't have to tell me twice. You're almost too good to be true, Sayori. That's why I question if you're real, and I don't deserve to have you in my, and if I deserve to have you in my life. To say that you think I do, though, I'm honestly kind of overwhelmed.
Trust me, Daniel. I am real. Even more than that, I want you in my life.
My body relaxes and I melt into Sayori's embrace. Sayori moves me closer to her, placing her head against my chest. This is kind of overwhelming, not going to lie. Before I can have a complete meltdown, Sayori breaks away from me and lies down in my bed. Sayori? What are you doing?
Coming in, Daniel. It's your bed, after all. It's so nice and comfy, too.
Are you sure that's a good idea? You still realize I have a cold, right?
Relax, Daniel. I'll be fine.
How do you know?
Hop in with me. There's no reason to be such a shy boy around me anymore. Now that we both know how we feel about each other, you don't need to be scared. It's only you and me. Nothing else matters right now.
This has taken quite the turn, but at this point, I can almost care less. I only hope I don't get her sick, but if Sayori says it's okay, then who am I to deny her? I proceed to adjust myself and lay down beside her. She gives me a rather interesting smile. The look of a predator!
Hi there!
Hi, Sayori. Sayori's looking at me lovingly, smiling as she brushes the hair away from my forehead. This is kind of awkward.
How do you feel?
Well, pretty good.
You see? Nothing bad is going to happen, Daniel.
Do you know what game we're in? Do you know who wrote the story?
Okay, well.
I'll always be here to take care of you.
Sayori.
Thank you. For real. You have no idea how much this means to me. You're welcome. I guess you could say I've always been attracted to cute, clueless, shy guys, if it isn't already obvious.
What? Oh.
Don't worry, it doesn't bother me at all. I think it only adds to how cute you are. If anything, it just makes me want to take care of you even more.
She surprises me once again when she pulls me in closer to her, kissing my forehead and cheeks repeatedly. She pulls away for a moment, giving me a sly smile.
Now, if only we could get rid of that nasty cold. I wouldn't have to be afraid about kissing you the way I've always wanted to.
I feel my face get a little warm. Where's that damn towel? Is it the fever? Is it because of how flustered I am right now?
I can't tell. I can't even tell anymore.
It doesn't matter. Do you mean that?
I love you, Daniel. I love you, Daniel, if I wasn't being straightforward enough with you. Honest. There's no reason for me to lie to you. I never want to hurt you or break your heart. Do you think I'm going to smother you in sweet kisses for some stupid prank?
Well, you have me there. Not even the girls who'd pull pranks on me would go that far.
I'm not like any of those other girls, Daniel. They're just too stupid to realize how much of a fantastic guy you are. It's their loss, honestly. None of them deserve to have you.
So I guess just a bit of developer commentary here. So, Night Nurse, much like most of the other mods in the Perfect World anthology, do take some basic ideas from Doki Doki October Horizon, which is back from the dead, so you can celebrate for that. And at least in that story, the MC did actually get bullied, everyone bullied him, especially, some of the girls in their school would too. So that's one reason why he makes that sort of joke about how, some of the girls would pull pranks on him just to be mean, and he's here none of them would definitely go that far. That would be just too damn cruel. And likewise, that line about how they first met is a reference to how they meet in DDOH. At least there's a flashback scene that kind of shows that a little bit. Unfortunately, it's not here, but, well. So, at least those are some little connections to DDOH, considering a lot of these mods are kind of spawned from it. At the very least, taking ideas from it and building on them a little bit. This all feels like a dream I've had so many times. I can't believe this is happening. I feel a random pinch on the side of my leg. Ouch!
See? You're not dreaming. I don't blame you, though. I can't believe I finally dared to make this happen. You've always made me feel kind of funny inside. Like having butterflies in your tummy kind of funny. After all this time, I've never felt this way about anyone else.
I've always felt the same way about you, Sayori.
These feelings I have for you, they're my honest, true feelings for you, and it's never made me feel so real. That's why I can't bear to think about you being in another woman's arms. Why, I'd never let you forgive myself if I let Monica or some other girl whisk you away without giving me a fighting chance.
Monica? What does she have to do with anything?
Exactly. I hope you and I can continue to only have eyes for each other. Remember that you don't need to be shy anymore or hold back around me, Daniel. Now, why don't you go ahead and lean back into my chest again?
I feel myself slipping away as I absentmindedly obey her, placing my head against her chest once more as she rests her chin on top of my head. Something has come over me, but I don't care anymore. Logic and reason have abandoned me. All of that has been replaced by my passion and desire to always be with Sayori.
Everything is all right now. You're all right. We're both going to be fine. Having you here with me like this just feels so right. I just want to continue taking care of you and keeping you safe.
I never want to leave your side.
Please, keep snuggling with me like this. I don't want to leave your side either. Would you?
Sayori suddenly becomes hesitant and almost kind of shy for some reason. If I don't have to be shy around you anymore, then you don't have to be around me too, Sayori. Tell me.
I know how shy you can be sometimes, Daniel, but you don't have to be that way around me.
I don't want to be a burden on anyone, especially not for you. I know most people would rather I stay quiet and out of the way.
You're not a bother to me at all. I want you to stay with me forever, Daniel, so stop running away from love.
You don't know how long I've yearned to hear you say that to me.
So, Daniel, would you like to sleep with me like this here tonight?
Or like to sleep with me here like this tonight?
I just want you to keep holding me tight and feeling your warm embrace. What do you think?
Do you ever have to ask? Or do you even have to ask?
I love you, my darling.
I love you so much, Sayori. Sayori gives a content sigh as she holds me closer to her. I can feel her breath going down my neck. At this point, I've completely forgotten about everything else in the world. The literature club, the music club, none of them matter anymore. Now, it's only me and Sayori. Just Sayori. You're all that I'll ever need, Sayori.
And you're all I'll ever need, Daniel. I should have listened to my heart in the first place and spoken up earlier.
No. If anything, I shouldn't have been such a spineless coward and ignored my feelings for you.
You're not a coward, Daniel. I wish you wouldn't talk about yourself like that. After all, you really are the light of my life. I don't even know if I'd be here if you didn't check in on me that fateful morning.
Oh, right. I was so scared out of my mind, Sayori. I thought I was going to lose you forever. Lose my best friend and the woman I loved. Forever.
Thankfully, you came to my rescue. You're You're like a storybook hero brought to life. Please, don't think so badly about yourself. For every single bad thing you say about yourself, I'll gladly tell you 1,000 things I absolutely love about you. Please, Daniel, never forget just how truly amazing you are.
Sayori, I feel myself breaking down. Seriously? Tears? Right now, of all times? As I try to hide my face from Sayori, she catches me and brings my face down to her chest once more.
Thank you, Sayori. You have no idea how much. It's no problem at all. I don't want to see or hear any negative thoughts you have about yourself. If I do, I'll just kiss them all goodbye and remind you how much you mean to me.
I never want to lose you, Sayori. Not now or ever again.
And you won't, so long as we stay dedicated to one another. We need each other. No one else can truly understand what we have.
We don't need any of them anyway. They're all just a bunch of lying, two-faced phonies.
Yeah. No better than Momoko and Destiny.
Those two popular bitches. What about them?
Oh, you know how they'd act all innocent around the teachers and then super nasty to whoever else they hated?
Know it. I wish I could forget about those stupid jerks. And yeah, another sort of... Momoko and Destiny are two bully characters that I wanted to introduce within DDOH. However, though, I kind of decided to sort of name drop them in here as well as with the three music club girls, just to kind of, well, not only establish that they do exist, but also because I kind of figured, you know, we need, or well, rather, I wanted to have Sayori kind of have something to kind of follow up with that two-faced phony line that MC has, where he's just here thinking like he's starting to feel like, I can't trust anyone else, Sayori is all I need, and you're kind of slipping into that mode of thinking. So then I just figured, well, maybe there should be some bully characters, or, you know, some two-faced girls that Sayori can bring up, and then, well, they came to mind. So, I ended up kind of giving them a bit of a sort of spot here, just to kind of, well, not only quote-unquote canonize them, but also to kind of serve as a bit of an example here for him. Especially Destiny.
Then you get my point.
And Destiny, specifically, is a reference to... Well, she's going to be very important to DDOH, let me say that.
I never told you this, but they bullied me a lot when they found out I had feelings for you.
I break away from Sayori, having calmed down from being so overjoyed, to look in her eyes.
What? Why? They just felt I was too happy and fake. They didn't want me to be a problem. One day, they ran into me in the bathroom and told me they had some dirt on me they could use to ruin my life. They said they'd tell you how I'd felt, as well as the whole school, and never let me live it down.
As if I needed another reason to hate them more than I already did. I'm so glad that... Who's the one with the ponytail?
Monica?
Yeah, whatever her name is. I'm glad she knocked them down a few pegs. Yeah, so you could kind of say that some events of DDOH are playing out in this universe, where Monika and another girl managed to put Destiny and Momoko in their place.
Yeah, that's so true. I guess Monika was good for a few things after all.
Who's Monika?
Oh, don't worry, Daniel. You don't need to think about any other girls ever again. Not when you have your wonderful girlfriend right here, who's super in love with you.
She says that name, but no one comes to mind. At least, no one I can remember. Should I know that name? I feel like I used to know someone by that name. It doesn't matter anymore, because she's right. And I don't need to think about any of those harlots anymore when I have you by my side. So yep, he's kinda sort of losing himself here. Oh god, this music is so scary. Okay, well then... Yeah, so I guess I'm gonna go ahead and sort of leave it here now. Okay, meanwhile, let's see, I'm just gonna make a bit of a separate section here for Attempt 2. So, this game does have multiple endings, and what you saw was one of those possible paths that we could travel down. So yeah, there's more than one ending to this story, much like a lot of these Perfect World Anthology mods have been. Alright, well then, thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys next time with whatever else I do. Stay golden, and later, folks. Can't you see I'm falling?